manifesto itself is born out of deep consultation, then the implementation of that manifesto would certainly follow that suit. And so you have no qualms, you have no doubt at all that the NDC, we have proven to always work with you. I do recall that even ESLA, Honorable Tekwe, had to do extensive consultation in order to take us to that route. And now we're talking of ECG. We have stated clearly that the losses are increasing. We were able to register and post some profits. Today, the losses are going so high because, one, there's a misalignment in terms of the tariff structure itself. If you look at the cost of power and what we are actually collecting, and if you look at the ADB document, there's a chart that tells you our collection. It's about 86%. What it means is that if you buy something for 100 CD and you go to sell it, you come home with 86 CD. So there's already a loss. And also government interference. The PURC is not doing its job independently. And let us be honest, we would reform the PURC and ensure that you can sit in your office and based on the indicators, project that the cost of electricity ought to be X, Y, or Z. It doesn't have to be an opaque system. And I'm promising you we will do that. When it came to the PSP, we went through a very transparent process. Just when we left office, the MPP took it and turned it around and mismanaged it. So the two of us are not the same. We initiated this PSP process through a very, very competitive and transparent process. If the NDC was in office, let me assure you, ladies and gentlemen, this scandal of PDS will not happen. It will not, not under President Mahama. He would not take state assets and hand it over to family and friends. That will not happen. And so we are two different people. We cannot be the same.